Hello guys, welcome to Tech Gadgets. Today we are going to discuss about different types of safety features right now available in cars. So like ABS, EBD and corner stability control, airbags and seat belts. So let's start. In car without anti-lock braking system, if you hit the brakes hard for too long, then one or more wheels will lock up and stop turning before the car comes to a halt. And when a wheel begins to drag or skid, the driver has effectively lost directional control of the car. And the best way to retain steering ability during a sudden stop in car without ABS is to brake hard, ease off slightly, and then repeat the same situation. What I am saying is for without ABS version cars. And with ABS, you can cross from the impact. For example, you can see here, there is a cone placed. So with ABS, the car has turned and it went in the straight way. But without ABS, the car has hit that cone. So in the same way, the best way to retain, as we know, the technique, and this technique is called threshold braking, works on the principle that a tire's maximum stopping ability occurs right before it begins to skid. And ABS does this automatically and faster and more precisely than most humans. Unlike us, mere mortal, ABS is able to modulate the brakes of only the wheel that's about to lock up. So, a four-channel ABS system consists of four main components, speed sensors for each wheel, and a computer-controlled valves on the hydraulic lines leading to each brake, and a pump for restoring hydraulic braking pressure, and an electronic brain overseeing the whole kit and to manage this. And when the system notices that one wheel is decelerating much quicker than the others, it knows that the wheel is about to lock up, and to prevent that from happening, it will modulate what wheel brakes pressure by closing and opening appropriate hydraulic lines. So this rapid opening and closing of valves is what causes the pulsing sensation to the brake pedal whenever ABS comes into play. So on some cars, there may also be a strain sounds from the system and the pedal may drop to the floor. And it is important to keep braking as hard as one to remember that ABS makes it possible to steer yourself out of danger. And many other safety systems such as stability and traction control make use of sensors and valves that are part of ABS. Okay, today safety is an important aspect in a car. And in India also, most of the cars are giving ABS to dual airbags and EBD as a standard feature. And the primary task of ABS is to give the driver steering control during hard braking and not reduce stopping distance, as is the general misconception. That said, given the right type of road and conditions, and that may prove to be the case. So on wet seal roads, ABS usually shortens the distance required for a stop, rather than dirt track. Skidding may actually decrease the stopping distance. Why? Because the car tires are able to dig into that surface. So the next safety feature is that EBD. So doctors say that the prevention is better than cure. In this case, wheel lockup, ABS can be thought as a cure. It only kicks it when the wheels are at a point of slipping, while electronic brake force distribution, EBD, is more of a preventive solution for the hardest and gentlest stops alike. And not all wheels require the same amount of brake force, because each wheel does a different amount of work. So most common braking scenario, a straight line stop. In this situation, the car weight shift forward, while with more weight have more grip and consequently are less likely to lock up. So in cars without EBD, there is a regulator valve in the hydraulic system that ensures that the front wheels receive more braking power. So here is the proportion of braking force distributed to the front and rear is fixed regardless of the circumstances. So this is perfectly acceptable solution, but it's far from ideal, as many things can affect a car's weight balance. So for example, an emergency stop will send more weight in front on the car than a gentle runoff or normal stop. During cornering, weight is distributed to the side of the car away from the corner, meaning that the inside wheels are far more likely to slip under braking. And there is a stolen of, as we all know, that EBD is able to cater for any of these situations. And as the EBD is an extension of anti-lock braking system, it can monitor each wheel speed and acceleration, deceleration to determine how much load it is bearing. By adjusting the valves in the braking system, hydraulic lines, EBD can distribute more braking force to wheels that are carrying more the load, less to that doing less work. So some EBD systems also monitor steering wheel angle and the car rate turns, So if the car is under steers or oversteers during mid corners, so braking, it can automatically brought back to the intended path. So as we all know that, and EBD works like that, and these are the sensors you can see about the ABS and EBD. So this is with EBD and without EBD, so loaded, and this is also loaded, so driver only. So the next comes is the braking assistance, and commonly referred to as either brake assist or emergency brake assist. EBA braking assistance does just that. It provides extra braking power when the driver attempts to perform an emergency stop. As a proportion of our driving lives, as we all know that, undoubtedly a good thing. It is also a slight, as many as are we are well trained what to do those times arise. So various studies have shown that in majority of test cases, drivers don't apply enough brake pressure during emergencies. So we might slam the brakes, but not quite hard enough to prevent a collision. Alternatively, we might get freaked out by unusual pulsing sensation through the brake pedal caused by ABS engagement and release the brakes, even a bit when more braking pressure is required. So these are the pictures, you can see that. And as we all know that braking distance with and without BA, here it is only 40 meters, and without BA it's 73 meters. So this is how the BA helps cars. And there is an autonomous emergency braking also that takes that idea one step further by either applying the brakes automatically without any driver involvement, or warning the driver of a possible accident and then applying the brakes automatically if he or she doesn't respond. That comes under autonomous emergency braking. Okay, so these are the different types of safety features we have. And typically autonomous emergency braking systems only cater for rear end collisions, as they are both the easiest form of accident to reliably predict and very common. According to the USA's National Transport Safety Board, 1/3 of fatal collisions are rear enders. So that is also one big issue. And the next safety feature is cornering brake control, and it's an automotive safety system introduced by car makers like BMW and Mercedes-Benz, and it is further development and expansion of the anti-lock braking system designed to distribute brake force during braking and cornering. It works by applying braking pressure symmetrically despite physically difficult conditions. Example, the car swerving towards the inside of the bend when the wheel load changes. So by asymmetrically distributing brake pressure to the left and right side brakes, or by reducing pressure, even if the driver brakes outside the normal range of ABS also, this will work as excellent. So that is corner stability control. And as we all know that airbags works when the collision happens. So how does an airbag work? So an airbag is an extra safety measure that commonplace in vehicles these days. And the SRS airbags, as you all hear that, it stands for supplemental restraint system, and it's intended to provide protection above that offered by seatbelt in the event of an accident. So how does it work? If your vehicle is in an accident where it hits another vehicle or object, or is hit, the airbag sensor, also known as the airbag ECU, will signal the airbag to open. And all modern vehicles have at least one airbag for the driver, which is in the steering wheel, and many also have an airbag for the passenger also. And right now most of the companies are offering dual airbags as standard. These are effectively large cushions that stop person going forward into the wheel dash or through the windshield. And the SRS airbag is tested by car computers every time the vehicle is switched on. A light will come on the dashboard, either a figure of a person with an airbag or just reading SRS. Once checked and found to be fine, the light will switch off again. If the light remains on, the car can still be driven, but the airbag won't operate. So please check, guys, if the light is still on and the ABS light is coming continuously, so there's a problem in the airbag. So to check the SRS airbag, a diagnostic must be run on the airbag ECU. which is in control module, it then needs to be cleared in order for the light to go off, and this work needs to be done by a trained professional with the proper specialized equipment. And some vehicles do offer side airbags which can keep the driver and passenger safer in event of being hit side on a vehicle. So however, these are only a minority of vehicles. And one more thing, most of the people think that if you don't fasten your seat belt, then airbags will not deploy and there is a sensor in the seat belt. No, there is no such kind of thing, and most of the people think that it's a myth, it's just a myth. And the sensors will be in front of the bonnet, and when a collision happens, automatically the airbags will deploy, whether you wear a seat belt or whether you didn't wear a seat belt. But if you wear a seat belt, then the collision will impact of the collision will be less on you. Why? Because when your car hits something, then automatically your airbag will deploy and it will retract. So in the same way, you will hit the airbag and the seat belt will pull you back. So that's the reason you have to wear seat belt. So hope that guys you like this video regarding safety features. Please comment and subscribe for my channel for more tech and auto related updates. Thank you.